नमस्कार, वी आर मीटिंग टुडे टू डिस्कस एंड प्रोबेबली रिमूव मिसकंसेप्शंस अबाउट द वैक्सीन एंड टू डिस्कस व्हाई, व्हेन एंड हाउ ऑफ द वैक्सीन दैट वी एवरीबडी इज ईगर टू टेक और सम पीपल आर ईगर नॉट टू टेक. सो द मेन पर्पज ऑफ मीटिंग is to simplify how we can take vaccine. Because of the WhatsApp University as well as unwanted literature which is pouring in from newspapers across the world, people get confused about all the issues in COVID, especially so about vaccine. So this is a small meeting. So the purpose of this meeting is basically to remove the confusion, and to start the meeting I am going to first confess to you that I am not a vaccine expert. I am a cancer surgeon, but why I am taking this education program is because probably I am a bridge between lay people and probably ID specialist and vaccine experts, because I am trying to simplify it and put it into your language as to what should be done. And like a surgeon, I will try and make it simple and straight, so there is no confusion at end of the lecture. So we will start today on this semi-technical lecture, which is COVID-19 vaccination. So the first question in COVID-19 vaccination is in everybody's mind is to why take the vaccine? Because there are people who feel that the worst of COVID has passed, 1 year is already over, then what is the necessity of taking this vaccine? So the first reason for taking the vaccine is protection against COVID infection, and the vaccine offers the protection in the range of 60% to 95% depending on the vaccine used. And this is a pretty high range of protection for us to compel us to take this vaccine. And this protection has been studied for a short time. Long-term studies are not available. Yet this is the best that we have got. So we should believe this data which has come to us from various vaccine manufacturers, as well as WHO has endorsed vaccines now. Government of India, the Drug Controller General of India, has approved the vaccine. So we should believe the data and understand that the protection is between 60% to 90-95%. The second claim of vaccine manufacturers is that vaccine protects against severe infections, and there is likelihood that you will not visit the ICU if you are vaccinated. That is also an important claim, and this claim is for about up to 90% protection against severe infection. So more than just COVID infection, severity of the infection is also low after vaccination, which is a very important point for taking the vaccine. And the third reason is a social reason, which is to break chain of COVID transmission in the society. This is very important, because if you have noticed, after the month of October, the incidence of COVID in Pune has been really low. In the worst month, around 15th of September, we had around 3,200 infections in a day in Pune city. That was the worst that we saw. 3,200 new cases in a day in Pune Municipal Corporation limit. And today we have around 150 to 200 cases a day. But this number has rarely gone below 100. That means more than 100 infections have always occurred in last 2 months. Now that means that the virus, instead of becoming epidemic, is now residing at an endemic level in our society, and it is not eradicated. Even now, I get one or two calls every day of somebody who is known to me who has COVID infection. So the virus is not going away. So as a society, we must all join hands together, get vaccinated, and try and fight this COVID infection. So it's a social responsibility, not just personal protection. Now the second question comes as to what are the types of the vaccines. So there are 4 types of vaccines, and as of today, 10 vaccines are approved by various clinical trials and various regulators across the world. So out of these 10 vaccines, the two most discussed vaccines are mRNA vaccines, which are produced by Pfizer and Moderna. Pfizer was the first company in the world which accelerated vaccination program, vaccination trials, and publication of results of its vaccine. And the vaccine is prepared by a German firm called BioNTech and distributed by an American company called Pfizer, and Moderna is also another American company. Now, this mRNA technology is unique, and for the first time in the world it has been utilized, in which they are synthesizing RNA like the COVID RNA. So it's a synthetic RNA prepared by genetic manipulation, and this RNA is given to us in the form of a vaccine. This RNA itself cannot cause COVID infection in our body, but it stimulates our body to produce antibodies. So mRNA vaccine is the first type of vaccines which came in the world. This was followed immediately by whole virus vaccines, especially from China, which was called as Sinovac. And now the second vaccine from India, which is Covaxin, from a Hyderabad-based firm, Bharat Biotech. Now, these two vaccines are using the entire virus, which is now non-living, that is a dead virus, and it is going to induce immunity in the body. So this dead virus, whole virus vaccine, is also under a lot of discussion across the world, and these two important companies, Bharat Biotech and Chinese Sinovac, are a hot topic of discussion. The third virus vaccine, which I have shown in blue, is our Covishield, which is researched by Oxford Institute in UK and produced by Serum Institute of India. Now, in which we are using an adenovirus as a vector. This adenovirus is a common cold virus, and on top of this common cold virus, they have put COVID virus spikes, which are the spike proteins. So it's a combination of adenovirus and COVID virus spikes. And these COVID virus spikes then produce immunity in our body and give us protection against COVID. The other two, like Sputnik from Russia and Janssen from Johnson & Johnson, are also adenovirus vector vaccine. And Sputnik is already in India. Janssen is about to enter the global market. The fourth type of vaccine, which is called as a protein subunit or spike protein vaccine, in which the virus is not used, only the protein subunit is used, is called, and that new vaccine is entering India for trials, is Novavax, and Serum Institute is again starting trial of this fourth type of vaccine. Now, when I describe these four types of vaccines, it looks like a confusion in a sari market, or when you go to a restaurant, it would be confusing as much as to which dish to order. And especially when people are afraid of their life, they are going to think that I must take the best vaccine in the world. So many people would think that I would buy a ticket to US or Europe, wherever, go take the best vaccine and come back. And many of us travel to Olympics or US Open or Wimbledon. So taking a vaccine abroad is no big deal for most of us. And yet, it is not a sensible idea, which I am going to discuss in the slides to come. So how to choose is a difficult issue, because I am going to tell you a story of the machines that we buy from these three big companies, which is Philips, Siemens and General Electric. These are the three big companies which produce CT scans and cath labs and MRI machines and PET scans. So these are the big radiology, nuclear medicine and cardiology manufacturers. And they always sell all the machines on all these three company platforms. And whenever a new machine from Philips comes for us to buy, the Siemens and GE guys come to us telling us all the negative points of Philips. And when the Siemens machines comes, the Philips and GE guys come to us telling us all the negative points of the Siemens machine. So much so that they give us a printout as to which questions we should ask these Philips, Siemens or GE people. And I sometimes suspect that they know more about other guy's machine than their own machine. And when we cross-check it with the company which is trying to sell us the machine, we many times find that the data is half true and sometimes even fully true. So they hide their weaknesses and they highlight opponents of their weakness of their opponents. So this is a tendency in all companies, and such has been the tendency of vaccine manufacturers. So they are also trying to highlight each other's deficiencies, creating a confusion in people's mind as to which one is better. For example, they started out saying that Pfizer is the only one which has studied vaccine effectivity over a prolonged time, and others have not given justice. Especially our own vaccine manufacturer started saying that Bharat Biotech has not done phase 3 trials. Now, similarly, then our people started saying that Moderna and Pfizer vaccines have given vaccine without antibody studies in its recipients during trial. That means those who had already had antibodies could have received the vaccine, and the result is a false 95% result. And all this dhulwad or whatever, that the mud that they are trying to throw at each other, only confuses us into thinking which is a better vaccine. So instead of going into all these four types of vaccines, my suggestion is that there is insufficient data to choose a vaccine that everybody across the world must agree and accept. That whenever the data is insufficient, then what we exercise is a judgment. And also there is shortage of vaccines across the world. Let us take UK for example, which is suffering badly from COVID as well as vaccine shortage. So UK is badly hit because of COVID, and they are trying to provide vaccine to the entire population, and the supply is not right. So my doctor friend Dr. Vasant Oswal, whom some of you might know, he received Pfizer vaccine first dose. His wife received Covishield vaccine. And now the second dose, which is due in 28 days, will be given after 3 months. In UAE, United Arab Emirates, that is in Dubai, 2/3 people got Sinovac, which is the Chinese vaccine, and 1/3 people got Pfizer. Then people started protesting that we don't want Chinese vaccine, Sinovac. They were told to leave the country if they don't take the vaccine. So trying to choose the vaccine is not a smart idea across the globe, because we do not know for sure if any of the vaccines are a solution to COVID. They are a hope in COVID. They are not by themselves a solution to COVID. But we must build upon that hope and work our way forward. So do not choose the vaccine. Use what we have got. So whatever vaccine comes our way, instead of trying to challenge that, it is better to take it and move forward. Who should take the vaccine? So the first is eligibility, and the published eligibility, the trials were mostly run on people between 18 to 65, because that is how all the trials in the world take place. The participants are between the age of 18 to 65. Pregnant ladies are not allowed to take participation in most of the drug trials. So 18 to 65, no pregnancies, that is normally the trial. Now, does it mean that a person of 70 or 75 should not take the vaccine? It is not so. Everybody too should take the vaccine. So the safe age is between 18 to 90. After 90 also people can take vaccine, but there have been some deaths in Norway due to vaccine in very old and frail people. And people are still trying to analyze whether the deaths are related to the vaccine or not. But it's a word of caution for everybody that if your parents are very frail and very elderly, I would generally say over the age of 90, it is better to wait for the safety reports and then take the vaccine. But anybody between the age of 18 and 90 can safely go ahead and take the vaccine. Government of India has announced that they will vaccinate all people above the age of 50. And that's a smart step because there are hardly any person above the age of 50 who is completely healthy. We have built such a society across the world that people over the age of 50 have one comorbidity or another, or at least our lungs are not right, our pollution levels are high, cities have become addas for COVID. So it is better that everybody above the age of 50 is vaccinated. It's a smart move, in which now I'm going to answer the future slides, which if you can see them, that is whether the diabetics and hypertensives and obese people should take. Yes, they must take before others, because diabetes, hypertension and obesity are risk factors for COVID outcome. They must take the vaccine whenever it is offered to them. Those who are taking blood thinners like aspirin or clopidogrel must take the vaccine. There is no kind of cross reaction between blood thinners and the vaccine. There was some confusion initially about Covaxin, which is the Bharat Biotech vaccine, being administered to people on blood thinners. That has now gone. Everybody who is on blood thinners must take the vaccine. People who are on immunosuppression, like transplant people who had a kidney transplant or liver transplant, those who are taking steroids for rheumatoid arthritis, those who had HIV or AIDS, those who had chemotherapy for cancer, all of them can take the vaccine. There is no contraindication of any immunosuppression to vaccine administration. So everybody between the age of 18 and 90 can take the vaccine. Whether people who had COVID infection should take or should not take, the answer is again, all those who had COVID infection should take the vaccine. All those who did not have COVID infection also should take the vaccine. COVID infection immunity may not last longer than 3 months in some cases, and it may last lifetime in some cases. So immunity after COVID infection is unpredictable. Currently, we don't have long-term data on immunity after COVID infection. So the smart move is that everyone, irrespective of whether they had or did not have COVID, should take the vaccine. So immediately the next question which comes is, who should not take the vaccine? So any person who is acutely ill because of any illness whatsoever, you have dengue, you have chikungunya, you have malaria, you have typhoid, you are down with acute treatment of cancer, you should not take the vaccine. You should take the vaccine when you have settled from the acute illness. Anybody who had a recent COVID infection within last 2 months should not take the vaccine. He should wait, at least have 2 to 3 months gap between his infection and the vaccination. So recent COVID infection, wait for 2 to 3 months. Anybody who had a life-threatening allergy, and what is a life-threatening allergy? It is not just rash, but the person's face swells up and he finds it difficult to breathe. So anybody who had any life-threatening allergy due to any drugs, antibiotics, vaccines, anything in the past, please discuss with your doctor before taking the vaccine. So life-threatening allergy, word of caution. Pregnant women, there is a debate going on whether they should take vaccine or not. There is no data from the trials. I have a feeling that in another 2-3 months, we will allow pregnant women to take the vaccine. But at present, we are not advising pregnant women to take vaccine. And lastly, people who had a severe neurological disorder, if you know of them, which is called as a Guillain-Barré syndrome or transverse myelitis, they probably may not take the vaccine. But that's an issue of discussion between the vaccine expert, neurologist and the patient. But it's just a word of caution. The vaccine is given. I'm going to talk mostly about Covishield vaccine because that is the one available in Pune. But wherever you are, you can go on internet and find out about the dosage and administration method of the vaccine that you will get. But for Covishield, It's a 0.5 ml intramuscular injection on the arm. You must have seen more than 100 selfies by now, because they are now recommending gluteal region injection because of selfies. That is what I have heard. But for the time being, it is given on the arm, 0.5 ml intramuscular. It is painless, and the whole procedure takes all probably 1 or 2 minutes to take the vaccine. You are asked to wait for 30 minutes post vaccination to see that there is no allergic reaction, anaphylactic reaction to the vaccine, and then you can go home or you can go to work. Preferably, I generally advise that keep 1 day's holiday after the vaccination, so in case there is fever or reaction, you don't have to cancel appointments. So for all our doctors who are taking vaccine in Dinanath, generally they have a holiday on the next day. Many of them are not taking that holiday, but it is potentially kept aside. So in case the vaccine has a minor reaction, please take 1 day's rest. The second dose is given after 28 to 42 days. Actually, it is after 28 days, but a good safe limit according to the trial is 28 to 42 days. So you don't have to become restless for the second dose between this time. And the government will send you a message reminding you that now you are due for vaccination, and which we are doing very promptly. And actually, I must compliment the government of India for the good job that they are doing during vaccination. The immunity protection from the vaccine comes 14 days after the second dose. There is some protection after the first dose, but it is halfway, that is 50% or so. But the real protection is after the booster dose, which is second dose, and 2 weeks after the booster dose, you have this somewhere between 60% to 90% protection, which will kick in, which is good enough for you to undertake your routine activities. Now, this is Dr. Samir Zog, and I'm going to play his video about his experience of the vaccination taken. I would request all of you to give a small round of applause to Dr. Samir Zog, because he was the general of our COVID fight against COVID in Dinanath Mangeshkar Hospital. We have treated about 13,000 patients of COVID, and he was instrumental in this fight. So let's run the video of Dr. Zog's experience of COVID. This is Dr. Samir Zog. He has been the main general of fight against COVID in the last 1 year. DMH has treated around 13,000 patients suffering from COVID infection. And Samir has been at the forefront of this fight. And today we are going to request Dr. Zog to share his experience of the vaccine that he has taken. He has taken the first shot. So, Dr. Samir, what was your experience like?
At Mangeshkar Hospital, we started vaccination on 16th of January when Prime Minister inaugurated the vaccine drive all over the country. And I took vaccine by my turn on 23rd of January. In DMH, there is an organized system of vaccinating 200 to 250 beneficiaries every day. My number came on 23rd of January, and I took the vaccine on 23rd of January. I did not experience any side effect from that, because that was quite hype in the social media that you get this side effect, that side effect. But I did not actually realize that I had taken a vaccine, and next 24-48 hours I was working throughout the post period in ICU as well as in the hospital. So be assured, take your vaccine when your turn gets, and it will save the world from COVID.
So that brings us to the next point. What are the side effects of the vaccine? Now, these side effects are seen in about 20% of people, and they are extremely mild. About 10% people complained that there was local pain and tenderness for a couple of days on the arm. That was not sufficient to kind of cause them any problem, because they were operating. Many of them were surgeons. Dr. Kurlekar took the vaccine, and next day he was operating as usual, even though he had mild pain in his left arm. But that was not an issue. Few people got rash only on the arm, none of them on the face. About 10% people got fever with chills. It was about 100 to 101 degrees for 1 or 2 days, mostly one day. And on the next day, they were back on the job doing their duty in the hospital or intensive care unit. So the fever was not alarming. And almost 15 to 20% of people experienced some malaise and fatigue, a little bit of being run down on the day or the next day of vaccination. Overall, after 48 hours, we did not have a single person complaining about vaccination. So far, 1,265 Dinanath Mangeshkar Hospital staff have taken vaccination. Out of these 1,265, none of them have taken leave for more than one day, and none of them have complained of any side effects after 2 days. So I feel that it is safe and it is harmless, that we are absolutely sure about it. Who are all the people who have taken? So I have put some senior figures for you: age 88, age 72, age 70, age 68, and of course down to age 25. All have taken vaccine with no regret or no side effects. So all in all, it has been a pleasant experience of vaccination. Many of them have taken vaccine after 55, 60, 70 years. So they enjoyed this vaccine shot after a long, long time. Very few of us are taking flu vaccine every year, unlike the Western world. So it's a good thing for us to learn flu vaccination. COVID is also another flu. There are some questions asked about this immunity which I am going to answer. The first is, how long will the immunity last? And the best immunity is seen 3 months after vaccination, and most probably it lasts for 1 year. The claim by Pfizer and Moderna is that their immunity will last for 3 years, but that claim has to be substantiated probably next or next to next year, and you have to take it with a pinch of salt. But at present, I believe that for most vaccines, the immunity will last for 1 year. But the good news is that first 3 months, immunity is at its highest. And the second wave of COVID, if it comes in Pune, it will be June, July, August and September. Unfortunately, like the last monsoon where we had COVID infection. So if the COVID is going to come back in June, July, August and September, the best time of vaccination is April and May. And while the doctors as guinea pigs are taking the vaccine now, and we are very happy to be guinea pigs at present, you people are lucky to get the vaccine in March, April and May, and which would be the best time, because you would be ready for COVID when it hits in June, July, August and September. So the immunity will last for 1 year. Best time is up to 3 months, and April, May would be a good time to get vaccinated. Second question people are going to ask is, when is it safe to go to business or start traveling around the world? The best time is 14 days after the second dose. So your immunity is probably at its peak, and then you can start doing routine daily business activities like before. Very old and frail people should take the vaccine after more safety data comes forward. I have a feeling that Covishield is safe enough for even old and frail people, and another month or 2 months down the line, we would advise them to take this vaccine. After the vaccine is given, the government is giving you a record that you have taken the vaccination. This record is in form of a certificate, and I'm going to show you the certificate, which will be important for you when you travel with this certificate. There are some people who are going to ask, what if I do not get vaccinated? And that's a question to which I would say the answer democratically is kind of everyone has a choice. If you don't take a vaccine, you are not an anti-national, you are not an anti-humanity person, you are not a COVID-friendly person, you just don't want to take it. And I don't think anybody can tell you or force you to take the vaccine. there might be some doctors or nurses who would not want to take the vaccine, and we must respect their choice and not humiliate them for not taking the vaccine. They are taking a risk. Number one is their risk of catching bad COVID infection that they will continue to take. And number two, they are not joining the chain of people stopping the COVID infection. But other than this, I think it is their choice. If somebody is mortally afraid of taking the vaccine, he need not take the vaccine. When you take the vaccine, it must be your choice. And the choice must be happy choice. Okay, it's not an unhappy choice to take the vaccine. You are not a child anymore. Only children take vaccine under duress. Adults choose vaccine, and everybody must make a statement as to I want to get the vaccine or I don't want to get the vaccine. Both are welcome. This is Dr. Parikshit Prayag, who is our ID specialist, and he is consulting probably many of the people whom are known to you for COVID, and this is his certificate. Dear Dr. Parikshit Prayag, you have been vaccinated with first dose of COVID-19. This message is from Union Ministry of Health and Family Welfare for obtaining your feedback. And there is an app which shows that he has taken the vaccine. The vaccination certificate can be viewed on DigiLocker in Umang app. So the vaccination certificate is available on mobile whenever you want to retrieve it. So that's a good thing government has done, and you will find it useful when you are traveling. So now we come to the main question as to how you all are going to proceed to vaccination. So the number one is that government is planning to finish healthcare workers vaccination by 13th of February. So by 13th of February, probably most of the healthcare workers, that is doctors, nurses, ward boys, receptionists working in the hospital, pharmacists, technicians, blood bank people, all of them will be vaccinated by 13th of February, following which the government will start frontline workers, which is police, bus drivers, train drivers, and frontline staff, which is exposed to the public. They will start getting vaccinated. And the third in line will be people above the age of 50, which probably is all of you. So you register for the vaccination and you wait for the vaccination. The wait is worth its while, because my advice to you is later the better, not earlier the better, because you should be ready for June, July and August of the COVID onslaught and not hurry for vaccination. If you get it in the month of March or April, that is the best time to get vaccinated. The vaccine at present is free of charge. We are not charging anything for vaccine to the healthcare workers, whether they are from Dinanath or from outside. I don't know what is going to happen when it is open for general public. The government may start some administration fee, or the government may bear the cost, or the hospital may bear the cost, as is the case in most government programs in the end. So somebody will bear the cost, but it is negligible or probably nil. So vaccine, the cost issue is not important in the vaccine. Every person above 50 and those below 50 with comorbidity like diabetes, hypertension, obesity will get the vaccine. And that's an assurance not only for the government of India, but as hospitals also, we want to assure you that we will do whatever is in our capacity to see that all this group is vaccinated. Do not worry. At the time of vaccination, all you need is Aadhaar card. They check the Aadhaar card. Some government person or the hospital authorities will check the Aadhaar card. Vaccination will be given. You wait for half an hour and you go home. It's as simple as that. DMH will definitely be a vaccination center, and we will accommodate all of you. So don't be in a panic mode to go for vaccination. If you get vaccine anywhere outside other than DMH, like if you are getting vaccine in Sassoon Hospital, Ruby Hall, Joshi Hospital or any other hospital, you can proceed and take it. There is no problem. in all the hospitals across the country, it is the same vaccine, it is the same method, and it is the same cold chain. So there is no superiority anywhere. Our staff is good, but I'm sure so is the staff of all other hospitals. So go ahead, take the vaccine. There are some post-vaccine precautions which I want to warn you about. Number one is that no vaccine offers 100% protection. Okay? So the moment you have taken vaccine, you are not a free bird. You cannot start socializing and throwing out the masks or burning the mask. You have to continue with mask, social distancing and sanitizer for next 1 year till COVID goes away. The vaccine is more to drive out as a community rather than as an individual. So we wait with all the measures for next 1 year in spite of vaccination. It's a community drive more than a personal drive. You always must have government certification for travel. It may save your RT-PCR tests on various airports across the world. I am not sure. But no government in the world will insist on a particular type of vaccine. That if you go to Russia, you must take Sputnik. If you go to China, you must take Sinovac. If you go to America, you must take Pfizer. That will not be the case because business and travel is always bilateral. And always to respect these bilateral ties, all the vaccines which are approved by the regulatory authorities will be accepted. So even if you have taken Covishield, you will be permitted to travel across Europe, USA, China or Russia. Do not worry. And do not worry about the type of vaccine that you have taken. Do not even boast about the type of vaccine that you have taken. All are similar. So to summarize that everything I have told you, the message is very simple. Register for the vaccine. Do get vaccinated. The vaccine is definitely safe. As far as Covishield is concerned, I can confidently say that in the 1265 people in DMH, those who have taken the vaccine, it was safe. All vaccines have pros and cons. Do not try to choose. It is good academic entertainment to discuss between the vaccines. Masks, social distancing and hand sanitization must continue for next 1 year. And the last word of caution again from my personal side is exercise, vitamin D and Jal Neti are far more powerful than any vaccine that our world has produced. Please continue to exercise all three of them till the COVID word disappears from the world. Because probably why India has done so well during COVID pandemic, so we are doing something different from the Western world. The Western world and our virus is the same genetic coded, same virus, there is no difference. We have done a lot better than the rest of the world. We will continue to do better than the rest of the world, provided we exercise caution after the vaccine and continue our exercise, diet, vitamin D, mask, social distancing and sanitization. So all in all, I think I will finish my talk on vaccine. I hope I have not created any confusion in your mind. I will take some few questions because Dr. Jog and other experts are there with me to answer any of the queries if I don't know about any of them. Please raise your hand so we will unmute you in case anybody has a query, and then we will proceed to this question answer session. Dr. Oswal, please go ahead.
By the way, good morning.
Good morning, sir.
A question about what you raised about community level.
Yes, sir.
How does it work on the community level?
If we vaccinate more than 50 to 60% of the people in a city or a country, there is a chance that at a community level, we will be able to fight incidence of the COVID infection and transmission of the COVID infection.
You're right. But I think the way to answer simply is, if you got infection of COVID, you've got 1,000 viruses in you.
Yeah.
if are not vaccinated, you're going to throw those 1,000 viruses out in the community.
Yes, sir.
Now, if you got vaccination, then maybe 500 of them will be killed in your body. So you will be shedding only 500 in the community. This is how the community incidence of COVID is going to go down as a result of vaccination, mass vaccination.
Yeah.
Not many people understand it, or it's not been made clear what we owe to the community apart from ourselves. Of
yes.
course, it's going to protect ourselves as well, because you're going to get a viral load much less on yourself because of vaccine.
Yes.
At the same time, community viral load will also be reduced on account of your shedding. Your shedding rate will be much less.
Yes.
So that's one point that I want to make.
Yeah.
And the point that you already made, that vaccine is a protection for yourself. It isn't going to prevent you from getting infection in the first place.
Yeah.
That you already made. But again, the emphasis is not really very strong on the part of the government or people, community workers, hospitals, etc. So this is an important point. I think the last point I want to ask you is a COVID vaccine available to choose from or to buy? As I understand it, no manufacturers are allowed to sell it in open market to an individual.
Yes, sir. So far, it is only provided by governments across the world.
Yeah.
There is no sale of any vaccine.
So you can't really choose which one you should have.
People, when they are trying to choose, they will wait for this to happen in future. That was the problem.
When Mangeshwar Hospital becomes a vaccine center,
yeah,
you're not going to have a choice of three on the desk and you say, which one do you want? That's not going to happen for a very long time, because all the vaccine production in the world has been taken up by the governments. It is not available on the open market anywhere in the world.
Yeah, there are 10 vaccines which are available in the world at present, and at least another 100 in the pipeline. Vaccine is very, very big business. So 6 months down the line, there would be vaccines available commercially, and people may be able to choose. But we should not wait for those 6 months to come. We should get vaccinated with the one that we have got whenever it comes our way. That was the message I was trying to give.
When you have a choice, you see, you don't really know at that particular time which particular vaccine will be available or effective against a variant. Because we're going to get variants down the line.
Yeah.
And very difficult for people to know which vaccine is the one which is going to have effect of South African or Brazilian or UK variant. So these are the practical issues.
That was the one question I did not answer about variants and what effect those variants will have on the vaccine. And I did not answer that question because the answer is still unknown to all of the world. No one in the world knows at present what will the South African and the Brazilian and the British variant, how it will react with the vaccine. So till we know this answer, we should not give the answer. That was the reason why I did not put it up in my presentation. Probably next year, when we take the vaccine number 2, today we are taking vaccine number 1 for 2021. When we take 2022 vaccine, probably this question would be the most important question to answer. So that is what I had in mind. So I did not put it up. Dr. Abhay Firodia.
Lovely presentation. Very, very clear. Everybody, I think, is very happy with the clarity you have brought.
Yes, sir.
One question that comes to my mind is whether people who take blood thinners have to discontinue blood thinners for 48 hours before taking the vaccine?
No,
or
sir.
They can continue to take blood thinners?
No, sir. They continue to take the blood thinners and take the vaccine on the same day.
Excellent. Thank you.
Yes, yes. Nandini. You go ahead, Nandini. Unmute yourself. Yeah.
Thank you so much for the time and the wonderful informative session, Dr. Dhananjay. The question I have is probably more apt for my family back in India.
Yeah.
Considering how active COVID has been in India, what I wanted to check was that, like you suggested, if you are COVID positive or you've had COVID, you should wait for a couple of months before you go for the vaccination.
Yes.
But potentially people might be COVID positive, but as asymptomatic. So do you need to test yourself for COVID before taking the vaccination, or would you still be okay if you go for the vaccination without knowing?
Yeah, there is no need of testing of antibodies before taking COVID vaccination. If you, let's say, had asymptomatic COVID infection 2 or 3 weeks ago and you take the vaccine, there is no harm which is going to come. What we are trying to ask people to take a gap for all those who had a reasonably bad COVID infection, not just positivity. So when you had a bad COVID infection, you should wait for 2 months. Asymptomatic COVID, only COVID positive, only on the test, they can take vaccination after 3 weeks. There's no problem. No need of antibody testing.
Okay, thank you.
Amruta. Amruta, unmute yourself.
Yes, sir. Thank you for the presentation, sir. It was very informative. One question I wanted to ask is, out of the 1,260 DMH staff which had been vaccinated, we would definitely have data as to how many were documented COVID positive who have taken in the vaccine. So did they have more flu febrile illness than the others, or there was no such difference?
Okay.
Purely on academic interest.
That's a very interesting question, because that is my observation. We are collecting data for it. But those who had a bad COVID infection, like fever, breathlessness, admission, severe body ache, these are the people who had a reaction to the vaccine also, which was a one-day reaction, but that reaction was there. So I would say 90% of people who had bad COVID had a one-day COVID reaction. Whereas those who did not have COVID or maybe had asymptomatic COVID did not have much of a reaction against the vaccine. So we are trying to kind of joke in the surgeon's room in Dinanath Hospital that if you had a reaction, that means you had a bad COVID. And if you don't have a reaction, that means you are probably good against COVID. But I would say that the reaction is so small that it is not important to dwell upon it. So I think whether you had or you did not have COVID, just go ahead and take the vaccine. Next is Nilima Kantak. Please go ahead.
No, very excellent presentation, sir. You have cleared all our doubts and you have even indicated the best time to take vaccine, that is between March to April, considering the second wave of COVID.
Yeah.
So, very well done.
Thank you. Oswal, sir.
There have been second doses given in the States. And some people that I know of had a bad reaction after the second dose. I don't quite know the explanation of it. Do you have any explanation why the second dose should cause reaction and not the first dose?
It's because of the antigenicity, because of the immune system, which is now sensitized to the vaccine second time, will have an antibody response, which is already primed. So it is not surprising that the second reaction is little more than the first. But even the second doses, because the trial for Covishield was taken in Bharati Vidyapeeth, to which I am kind of friends with and affiliated. So in Bharati Vidyapeeth, the second doses were given to the trial participants. They did not have much of a reaction for the second dose also. So as far as Covishield is concerned, I am pretty confident that the reaction is not significant. For Pfizer or Moderna, I think we will have to rely on the data from United States. But most of the doctors I know from US have taken second doses without much of a side effect. So I really am not worried.
There is a lot of skepticism about the Novavax cases, and 23 people died. Of course, they were frail and everything else.
Yeah.
And if I was given choice that I want to die with a severe allergic reaction to the vaccine or with the COVID, you know which way I'm going to choose.
No, no, sir. No discussion of death on the vaccine front. That's the rule.
I think it's very misconception
among
a lot of people, not medical people, a lot of people, that they are getting some reaction. Well, you say there is a difference between side effect and adverse effect. Now, side effect tells you that you actually had vaccine working for you because it's producing inflammatory reaction in you, which is a good thing. That's what we aim.
Yep.
So it is not a bad effect, but it's a side effect of taking vaccine.
Yes.
Whereas adverse effect is the one
which unwanted.
Allergic reaction.
Unwanted reaction. Yeah.
Unwanted reaction.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Anybody else? Mani, you were going to say something. Mani, go ahead.
Yep. You talked about we have to get ourselves registered for the vaccination.
Yes.
I don't know what are the process for that.
It has not started yet. When it starts, we will immediately inform you. Even the newspapers and media will also inform.
All right. Okay. All right. Thanks.
Manoj, go ahead.
मला एक प्रश्न विचारायचा होता की फर्स्ट डोस वॅक्सिनेशनचा घेतल्यानंतर 28 ते 42 दिवसात सेकंड घ्यायचा
बरोबर
पण त्याची इम्युनिटी एक वर्षापर्यंतच असू शकते तर मग एक वर्षानंतर परत घ्यायला पाहिजे का तो
अशी शक्यता आता 99% वाटते
हे दरवर्षी हा घ्यायला लागणार असं
असं वाटतंय याचे लॉंग टर्म स्टडीज उपलब्ध नसल्यामुळे याबद्दल कुठलंच कॉन्फिडंट विधान करणं बरोबर नाहीये
ओके पण मग आमच्या सारख्या लेमॅनला साधारण 50 पुढच्यांना
एक वर्ष
मार्च मध्ये मिळायची शक्यता आहे म्हणजे
बट इफ यू लुक ॲट द हिस्ट्री ऑफ स्पॅनिश फ्लू द स्पॅनिश फ्लू विच वॉज देअर इन 1918 डिसअपियर्ड इन 2 years सो वी ऑल्सो एक्सपेक्ट दॅट द कोविड मे डिसअपियर आफ्टर 2 years इफ इट डिसअपियर्स द वॅक्सिन प्रॉब्लेम विल बी सॉल्व्ह फॉर एव्हर दॅट इज द रिझन वाय दीज कंपनीज आर कॉम्पिटिंग सो मच विथ इच अदर
ओके
राहुल गो अहेड
Thank you. Any update on any charity methods? Do you do it once a day, twice a day, or any changes to what you've been suggesting
earlier? I personally do it twice a day, but at least once a day is what I recommend, at least once a day. I personally do it twice a day because when I go back from work, that I feel is the best time to wash out whatever viral particles that I have caught during work. And in the morning, it has been my practice for many years now to do it. So I'm doing it out of habit. But if you have to do it once a day, it would be at the end of the work. That is the best time to do.
End of the work. So it's and in terms of, let's say, if you come back from a place like a restaurant or something, do you have to do it after that or it's not necessary? You just do it once a day. That's more than enough.
Once a day is at the end of your working day, which includes your dinner at night.
थँक्यू
आरती गडकरी तुम्ही अनम्यूट करा स्वतःला
केला आता येतोय आवाज
हो येतोय बोला बोला
हा माझा प्रश्न असा होता की ऑटो इम्युन डिसीज असेल एखाद्याला
हो
तर आणि स्टिरॉइड्स असतील किंवा नसतील व्हॉट एव्हर तर सेफ आहे का वॅक्सिन
काही प्रॉब्लेम नाही कुठलाही इम्युनो सप्रेसिव्ह एजंट किंवा काही चालू असेल तर वॅक्सिन घ्यायला काही अडचण नाही यू कॅन गो अहेड अँड टेक द वॅक्सिन
ओके चालू नसेल तरी हरकत
नाही हो
ओके थँक्यू सर
ओके छान लेक्चर कमिंग टू द एंड ऑफ द डिस्कशन वी विल हॅव अ लास्ट चॅट विथ डॉक्टर ओसवाल बिकॉज ही इज ऑल्सो अन ऑथॉरिटी ही इज अ व्हेरी फेमस ईएनटी सर्जन फ्रॉम युके अँड ही इज अ मेंटॉर फॉर ईएनटी डिपार्टमेंट इन दीनानाथ मंगेशकर हॉस्पिटल अँड ही इज नॉलेज अबाउट वॅक्सिन एज वेल एज अबाउट कोविड इज एज सबस्टॅन्शियल एज अवर ओन सो वी विल डू अ लास्ट talk with Dr. Oswal before we wind up and then we will close the session. Possibly after 6 months or 1 year, we will come to know the success of this vaccination program in India. At present, Israel is the country, first country in the world, which has claimed that all vaccinated people, the incidence of infection in them is 1% or less. This is what, now the time is short, but Israel has claimed that 1% infection rate in vaccinated people. So that's good news coming from Israel. We will have our own good news after 6 months or 1 year. Over to you, Dr. Oswal, sir.
Yes, thank you very much. Can you hear me now?
Yes, sir.
You can, yeah. I just want to summarize what yes. you said so far. Viruses are there everywhere.
Yes.
We're used to having flu jabs every year.
Yes.
So this virus may not ever go. If it didn't go, it might be replaced by another variant.
Yes.
As it is happening with flu vaccination. So time will tell us whether this vaccine, this virus is going to go altogether or not. Just as an information, smallpox virus was eradicated from the world, but it took 200 years
to eradicate
vaccination of every single person in this earth, on this earth. So it may happen, it may not, but I think it's a yearly vaccination program is what it looks like for COVID at the moment.
Yes, sir.
Why yearly? Because either your antibodies are going to last for a year, which I doubt very much, or the virus is going to mutate. We know that flu virus at the moment mutates every 9 months or so. It starts from east and comes to the west. Now, how often this virus is going to mutate, I think it's a bit of a big question mark, because we already have mutation in the last 6 to 8 months. 3 or 4 or even 17 mutations have occurred. So if the mutation occurs often, then the current vaccine will have to be tweaked to cover that particular mutation and treat that particular group of people or town or postal code or whatever it is where mutation has occurred.
Yes.
Just to give you an up-to-date information about UK,
yeah,
we have detected South African virus down south.
Yes.
And we have isolated those by postal code. And 80,000 odd people are going to have test today and tomorrow.
Yes.
And any of those who are positive for South African virus will have to be strictly isolated so that they don't spread that particular variant to the rest of the country. So this is another aspect of where experience. Now, out of all the South African variant positive cases, interestingly, only 11 cases actually did not give any history of travel to South Africa or any contact. So whether they had a similar in-situ mutation as South African is what we are looking at the moment. So mutation, I think, is a big issue in connection with the vaccine.
The flu virus.
Thank you very
much. To end it on the good note of this mutation is that when we take the dose next year or probably whenever there is a mutation, probably that will be a single dose, because now our immunity is already primed against this basic virus, which is mRNA virus. So whatever mutation comes, most likely it will be a single dose next year onwards. That is my impression about vaccinology. But all in all, I think it looks good. It looks exciting to kind of take vaccine and beat the virus. Virus has beaten us for last 1 year. Now it is time to give back something to the virus. So I think
Johnson is already.
Yes, sir. So yeah. So now we do something back against the virus as a community. And thank you all for joining for this session. It will be available on YouTube. So it's goodbye and thank you from Mangeshkar Hospital.